a video for the teachers. In this video, I am going to discuss about issues of online examination. There are two issues, one from the teacher side, one from the student side. These are the issues which were come up while conducting the online examination. Teacher side, it is subject wise or semester wise. Can we have a single Google Classroom or we have to have a different Google Classroom for the different subjects? How to handle the late submission? How to monitor the things? Whether the mobile is good, whether the laptop is good, and how to prepare the mark list. From student side, it is issues related with uploading, internet connectivity, number of pages, and how to contact the teachers. The first issue we will take up of the students, that is the uploading one. For uploading, you have to see to it that one, the PDF file which is generated after the scanning, it should have the minimum size. So we have conducted a small, what they call, information regarding this. This data is collected from the files which were uploaded by the student itself. Randomly 10 PDFs have taken, and number of pages, what is the file size, which software is used, whether the student has ended in right time or late. These all things are tabulated in one, and with this data we can come to a conclusion that one, on an average, we can have a file size of 8.5 MB. So we can easily upload this to the internet. The time taken to the uploading of the internet also can be calculated by this particular formula. That is, time in minutes is equal to file size in MB divided by upload speed in MBPS. So this table shows the different times for the different internet speeds. So you have to remember that one, the file size is in megabytes, that has to be converted into megabits, so which is the internet speed. So in this way, so we address the issue of uploading one. So we can calculate the upload speed, or we can use different softwares to cut down the size of the PDF file which is generated after the scanning. The next issue is with the internet connectivity. Normally students always complain about the internet connectivity. So we given some guidelines to the students. So we asked them to use the CAM scanner, because we found that one which it creates a minimum size PDF file, then this is the formula to be used to calculate the speeds. And even we asked the students to calculate or note down the internet speed by visiting this site, speedtest.net. So it has been found for the Jio itself, it comes out to be 3.73 megabits per seconds. Even after the what you call plan, the minimum normal internet connection will be around 0.064 megabits per second. So these all have been considered in the our data analysis. So we found that one, a average size of the file will be 8.5 MB, and the time to upload is, it will be somewhere between 2 minutes to the 10 minutes. So we asked the students to calculate their own upload time and plan according to that. The number of pages. The number of pages, as such, there is no limit for the number of pages. But in given time of 1.5 hour, we allotted 1 hour for the write up, 15 minutes for the downloading, and another 15 minutes for scanning and uploading. So in 1 hour, students can write around 10 to 15 pages, and it has been observed that one, the students have written up to 10, 12 pages, and when they scan it with the proper what you call scan software such as TapScan or the CAM scanner, their file sizes comes to be somewhere around 4 to 5 MB. So there is no such restrictions on the number of pages. Students can write as many pages as you want. Next is how to contact. So there are three different ways by which we can contact the teachers. One is a communication between private, that is between the teacher and an individual student. Then a communication between teacher and to the whole class pertaining to a particular subject. The third way of communication is, it's a general communication. By using this option of stream, we can communicate to each and everyone in the class. Let's see these one by one where they appear in the Google Classroom. This is Google Classroom page. You can see this one. The whatever here is there, it is a communication with the whole class. So you can create what you call messages for the whole class. Like this, I have here, I have made streaming 15 minutes past, late submission not done, late submission not considered, like this. This will be broadcasted to the all the students. So in this assignment page itself, you will find that one for this particular subject. You find here four class comments. So these are the class comments which were taken place between the teacher and the student pertaining to that particular class only. Any issues with the class particular subject, we can communicate in this window. Here comes the private communication between the teacher and the students. You can see here I have communicated with the particular student who is having issues with the internet connectivity. Okay, so here you can, student can return his comment in the same way. So in this way we can have a connectivity between the teacher and student, private class comments and the stream. So here is the issues which are related with the what you call teachers, that is subject wise or the semester wise. All subjects of a semester can be included in a single room. Again, visit the Google Classroom. Here you will find the people. So you can see here I have included all the teacher pertaining to a particular semester. So in this way you can put up all the teachers in a single classroom. So students can log into the single classroom to submit different subject answer scripts. Monitoring is the second issue. As we don't have any video connectivity, we cannot monitor the students directly. This examination will be something like open book examination. So we can frame the composite questions rather than framing the more number of questions, which will lead to the some difficulty in evaluating one. The composite questions are something like that: define, classify, and write the application. You can ask the specific application, you can ask specific things in the question so that the student has to work out and answer the questions. The next issue is of the late submission. How a teacher will come to know about the late submission? For this we have to conduct some post processing. So this post processing is conducted by using the emails which were generated by the Google Classroom for the each and every submission. For every submission of student, each subject, each semester, you will get a notification. So this notification will help us in tracking the late submission of the students. How it is there, let's see in the Google Classroom itself. So here you can see it has come turned in late. So here also will get done late. To know the late submission of the student, you have to go to the Gmail and you have to go to the updates, so where you will find the dates and other details. If you just scroll in, so you will get the idea. So here is the one submitted late, the subject name is coming. So here you will get the, what you call, the date. Okay, if you click it, so the Google Classroom will give you the information that one, that he is submitted 2 days late. Like that, number of time at which he has submitted late, this also will come in the Google Classroom, but you have to view it in the Google Mails. Next issue is the use of mobile or the laptop. For evaluation, the mobile is the best one because the editing option is only enabled in the mobile, as Android phones are capable of doing much more than the laptops. So evaluation process, I recommend you to do it on the mobile itself. So where are all other activities, the laptop is the better one, but you can do it on the mobile also. So mark list we can generate using the Google Classroom itself. So let's visit the Google Classroom one more time to see this one, how the Google Classroom generates the consolidated list. So this is the Google Classroom. Again, you can go to any subject. That when you click into the assignment tab, you will get all this like this, assigned, tuned, graded. So here is the, what you call, icon for setting. Just click on that one and here you will come copy all grades to the Google Sheets. Just click on that one. So your Google Sheet will be ready. So here is the Excel sheet which is generated by the Google. All information is here. So student name is there. Email IDs are there. What percentage every student has scored. Class average is also here. So here you can see that one, the subject names here. These subject names we have put in assignments title bar. So just write the subject name in the title bar. So it will be reflected in this sheet like this. It tells on which date it has been taken, what marks it has there. And like this, you will get a consolidated Excel sheet. This sheet you can download it. So you can download it directly, the Excel sheet, or you can direct it, you can download it as a PDF file. So in this way, the Google will allow us to generate the consolidated mark list of all the subjects for a particular semester. I have discussed the issues which are related with the teacher and the students, which I came across while conducting the online examinations. Hope this video series on online examination will help the teachers. Thank you for watching all the 3 videos.